Welcome to week one of Back to Biz Basics Flourish Edition. We're going to make a relatively simple line chart here in Flourish of Major League Baseball player salaries. This is a graph we're going to create. Again, the way I'm trying to set this up is I'm going to show you how to create the basic graph, so basic line chart. We'll take a short break, go try to make it if you haven't already, and then we'll come back and I'll show you how to extend it a little bit. And in this case, fairly simple. I'm just going to add some annotations here and I'm going to fill in the area between the lines. So this is what we're going to create. Let's go back. I'm actually going to show you how to add that logo there too, because I think it's kind of neat. Not necessary, but kind of neat. So I have my Flourish structure set up like this, week one to week two. I'm already building things out. So we're going to create a new visualization. Just going to go to new visualization and I'm going to click that line chart and it's going to pre-populate. And so what I need to do is go into my data tab and go grab some data. So I'm going to upload my data and I'm going to grab the first data set here. Now, this is important to note, if you haven't used this before, when you read in new data, it overwrites what's there, which is generally fine, except that if you just want to update the data and not all the selections you've made on the right side. So this automatically choose columns will always sort of apply. So that's going to become clearer in more complicated visualizations. Maybe you're making something in Flourish, you're going back to your tool, your Excel, Google Sheets, R, whatever. You make some changes and then you come back to Flourish. When you upload the new data, you want to uncheck this box. But for now, it's fine. We just have new data. We're just going to load it up. It tells you exactly what's uploaded. Terrific. Click continue. And I've got my data. And it's already going to make some decisions for me. It's going to prompt me, right? So it's already figured out the year here. That's time. And it's got numbers for the minimum salary and the average player salary. So that's great. Looking good so far. I want A and B and C for my values. Let's go to the graph. That looks pretty good. I want to make some changes here, right? I want to make some basic changes. So first thing I want to do is I want to change the colors of these two lines. I don't love these lines. So we're going to do some overrides here. And this is really easy. And you can just click in the little box here to figure out. But basically, all you do is take the variable name. I'm just going to go back, the column name. And then you're just going to put in a colon and whatever color you want. I'm going to use a hex code. I'm going to use this. I already have this set. Obviously trying to do a little bit of work so you don't have to watch me struggle too much in these videos. And so we're going to make 2, 2, 3, 4, 8. These are going to be two colors. We're going to use orange and blue for our two colors here. So that's pretty nice, right? Like I already got that kind of set up. All right, that's great. Let's make some other simple changes. Let's just set up our header here. Let's write a title here. And in this case, I'm just going to say average MLB player salary almost reached $5 million in 2023. So you notice the data ends here in 2023, even though the time ends in 2024. So we're going to fix that as well in a second. Okay. So this is pretty close to what we would want. Let's do one more change here. Let's change our x-axis. I want it to stretch on just on that 20-year period. So I'm going to change the minimum date to 2003 and the maximum date to 2023. So I can actually just do this manually right here. And then I actually want to have these x-axis labels be horizontal. So down in the x-axis, ticks and labels, styling, I'm going to change this angle to 0 degrees. And now I'm going to get that. And so that's pretty nice. That's pretty good. We need probably a title here. So let's add a title. Let's just say salary. Salary looks fine. We could do that. We could leave. Oh, that's the x-axis. I don't want it there. My apologies. Let's go to the y-axis. And we want the title here to be salary. That's what we want. Now you can change this styling as well. I don't know if we always need it to be bold. You know, maybe regular is fine. Maybe that size is fine. That's obviously a style decision. The other thing though is like, I don't know if we need all these zeros here. So let's change the number formatting. I want to do two things with my number formatting. I want these to all be dollars, right? So that's $3 million. And you'll notice here that there's no option in the data tab to add a dollar sign in front of that number. That's not a format that exists in Flourish, but we can add a prefix to that. And so now all of our values are going to have dollar signs in front of it. That's great. I don't think we need all the millions. So let's just divide. Let's divide by a million here. And you're going to see we're going to have our millions. And you can see in the pop-up box, it's also a million. So, you know, whether that's good or bad, I don't necessarily know. But you can't really control the how the numbers are formatted in one place versus another place. And so that's going to potentially be an issue that'll come up later. The last thing I'll do is just quickly, let's just add a legend here. I mean, I do like the labels are right here, but let's just kind of play around and let's try those labels there and turn those labels off. And so now we've got a pretty simple basic line chart. So straightforward, we have at our title, a legend, salary, these are millions of dollars. Maybe we want to do one last thing. I'll do one last thing and let's make this salary dollars millions. That way it's clear that these are in dollars and millions. Okay, so that's a start. Get this graph set, pause the video, get this graph set, come on back, and we're going to take it one step further. Okay, welcome back. We've got our graph. We're going to do just a few simple things to kind of make this, just kind of take it one next step. That's all. Let's shade in the area between these two lines. I've always liked this approach. I think it's just like a nice, I just think it's like nice to fill it in. So what we can do is we can go into the lines, dots, and areas menu. And down here, it's already built in. There's a shade areas between line menu. And so a little toggle. I'm going to turn that on. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to follow how they describe it here, which is just put the two series with double colon. And so I'm just going to copy and paste. I have this over here. And I'm going to click out of that. And look at that. I've got a nice shaded area. I can even change the color here. Maybe make that a little lighter. Maybe that's a little too light. I'm going to draw this down just a little bit. All right, that's looking pretty good. Let's do an annotation. So annotation is obviously very important to data visualization, effective data visualization. Let's add a little range here. So we're going to put a highlight on the x-axis. So that's where we're going to want to put our range. And what I'm going to do is I want to make this little dip kind of clear, because what's going on there is COVID. And so what we're going to do is label the area, the time between 2020 and 2022 with that COVID label. So it's going to be my label. You see down here, my label, 2013, 2015. I'm going to do 2020, 2022. When I tab out, you can see that I get that COVID-19. It doesn't quite fit here, but I could change the height of the chart. That's another option I can do to make that a little bit easier to read. So if I go down here, I can change the margins, or I could change the entire height of the chart if I wanted to make that a little bit bigger. The last thing I might want to do is to change the footer. So let's change the source name here to back to Viz Basics week number one. And so you could see it adds the source right there. Source label's already sitting here, so that's kind of nice. I could add a URL if I wanted to do that. I could also add an image. If I want to drop a little image in here, see if I can find, here, I'll drop the back to Viz Basics image right at the bottom. And that's a little small, so I might have to make that a little bit bigger. See if I can make it bigger here. There we go. Just click, 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 click. And we'll just make that 4. That's a nice round number. But you see just adding that little logo there is really easy to do. And so now I've got a chart where I've got the label here. And the last thing I'll say, one last thing I could do, is to change the pop-ups. I can really style the pop-ups here. I can change lots of things. I can change what's in the header. So right now, once I turn on the custom, it's all default language. But if I leave it on auto, you see average player salary, 2015. So let's just real quickly, let's change the header. And we'll just leave it at that. So I'm going to click that button. In the pop-up header, I'm going to put, I'll put just the year, just to show you how it works. I'm going to put the year in there. And so when I click now, you can see the year is up there. So that's just one thing you do to play with the pop-up. So I would encourage you to sort of play around with that. But I do like how, at its core, the colors of the text match the color of the line, as you can see here. So that's how you make a default basic back to Viz Basic line chart in Flourish. Let me know if you have questions. Subscribe to the channel so you can keep up with the project. And when you share your visualizations, make sure you tag me as well as Erica and Elisa and the rest of the Back to Biz Basics team with the hashtag B2VB. And stay tuned for more videos and learn how to create visualizations in Flourish.